this video, we'll now try to see the internal structure of stem. The first section that we are seeing is a transverse section of dicot stem. And the reason why we are starting with dicot stem is because this is one stem where we find or we are able to see all the stages of secondary growth very nicely. So we'll start with dicot stem, understand its primary structure, and then we'll discuss the secondary growth in dicot stem. And then we'll do it with all structures. That is, after this, monocot stem, normal structure, and growth, if at all. Then root structure and the secondary growth. Now, in dicot stem, when we cut the stem, what we find is a circular part. This is a transverse section. And there are many vascular bundles which are arranged in a ring. So, ring-like arrangement of vascular bundle is a characteristic feature of dicot stem. Now, let us start with the outermost layer. We have seen all the tissues and tissue systems. So, outermost layer is made up of the epidermal tissue. Epidermis is made up of flat parenchymatous cells, and the outer side may be covered with cuticle to prevent water loss. So there can be a cuticle layer outside it, or there could be some structures which are in the form of multicellular structures. These are called the hair or trichomes. This red layer that we have drawn is actually the cuticle, which may or may not be present. So this is the cuticle. And the single layered cell which we have drawn, this is the epidermis, outermost layer. Now, below epidermis, and there is a layer inside which is called pericycle. Between these two layers is present what we call the cortex. Cortex is divided into three zones. Just beneath the epidermis, there are few layers of cholenchymatous cells. Cholenchymatous cells are the cells where there is deposition of pectin, and because of this deposition, the intercellular spaces are gone. So we are filling these spaces with pectin-like material. So this is cholenchyma. And we have also studied that cholenchyma is the living mechanical tissue. So this layer which we have drawn here is cholenchymatous hypodermis. Hypodermis. And in hypodermis, which is made up of cholenchyma, its function is to provide mechanical support. It is having those thick edges, and the deposition is of pectic material, which we normally call the pectin, which is deposited here. Beneath this are present parenchymatous cells, which are loosely arranged. And because they are loosely arranged, we are able to see the intercellular spaces. And because I'm using the same color to draw parenchyma and cholenchyma, it is easy for us to distinguish between the two types of tissues. In cholenchyma, we find these thickenings and loss of intercellular spaces, whereas in parenchyma, those spaces are clearly visible. Innermost layer, let me label this, this is known as the parenchymatous cortex. Parenchymatous cortex. This is the second layer. The outer one is hypodermis, then the parenchymatous cortical layer. innermost layer of cortex is made up of, again, little barrel-shaped cells without intercellular spaces. And this layer is known as the endodermis. Endodermis. These three layers together, that is hypodermis, then parenchymatous cortex and endodermis together form the cortex. So cortex has basically three layers or three sublayers. Hypodermis just beneath epidermis, then a parenchymatous band and the endodermis part. Endodermis has starch deposition. So there is starch which is deposited in this endodermis. So innermost layer of cortex is endodermis, outermost layer of cortex is hypodermis. Function of hypodermis is to provide mechanical support. And when we were talking about the tissue, we said colenchyma, parenchyma, etc., they help or they fill the gap. And that is why we call them the ground tissue. Now coming to the structure which is inside. The layer which is inner to the endodermis is called pericycle. And this pericycle is made up of two types of tissue bands. It has parenchyma as well as sclerenchyma. So I'm showing this much part so that we are able to see two vascular bundles. So let me draw one vascular bundle here and one here. They will be arranged in a ring. So we are showing only two. The pericycle layer has two types of cells. There are sclerenchyma cells and there are parenchyma cells. Sclerenchyma cells are present just above the phloem part. The outer part is going to be phloem in the vascular bundle. Here is going to be the cambium strip and inner is going to be xylem. So here the pericycle part is going to be sclerenchymatous. This is to provide again support. Again here there would be this sclerenchymatous pericycle. And in between these bands, there is going to be the regular parenchyma. So here the loosely arranged cells. So this complete band is known as pericycle. Pericycle has two parts, sclerenchyma and parenchyma. The sclerenchyma part is in the form of spindle shape. Normally, we have drawn it like this, but the shape is something like this. They are arranged in the form of this spindle-like or semi-lunar type of shape. And in between are present the parenchyma cells. Now, these parenchyma cells are present in between this vascular bundle also. So, let us see how these parenchyma cells are placed here. These parenchyma cells are getting squeezed between the vascular bundles, and because of which they are becoming little elongated. Parenchyma only, but because they are getting squeezed, they look little elongated. This is known as medullary ray or medullary rays. Their function is lateral conduction. So they help in lateral conduction. Now, again, we are coming to the central part. As there is nothing between which this parenchyma would squeeze, so inner cells are again loosely arranged. And this mass is known as pith. So what all structures have we seen? The outermost layer is epidermis, which may be covered with cuticle. Below it is hypodermis, which is colenchymatous in case of dicot stem. Then there is parenchymatous cortex. Endodermis, which is rich in starch. Pericycle, Pericycle has parenchymatous and sclerenchymatous patches. Sclerenchymatous patches are on or just above the phloem. Now, this is the vascular bundle. In vascular bundle, there are cambium strips. Phloem is on the outer side and xylem is on the inner side. So, let us write down few things about the vascular bundle. In case of dicot stem, the vascular bundle is conjoint, collateral, and open. Conjoint means xylem and phloem on the same radius. Collateral means phloem on the outer side, xylem on the inner side. And open means they have this cambium. This is the vascular cambium. So when we make the vascular bundle, what exactly are we going to make? We are going to make this meristem, which is known as the cambium. It is called vascular cambium. Outer side has phloem. So here when we show phloem, we'll show the sieve tubes with companion cell. One more sieve tube with companion cell, phloem parenchyma and phloem fibers. So this is the phloem part. Cambium is the meristematic part. And now coming to the xylem part. Here, xylem is endarch. So outer is going to be metaxylem, which is bigger. As we move towards the inner side, that is towards the pith, the xylem will become smaller, that is protoxylem. So in this case, the xylem is endarch, this is phloem, and this is xylem. So vascular bundles are open, conjoint and collateral with endarch, xylem. These are the primary tissues. Primary means the first formed tissues, in which from outside to inside, the sequence is going to be epidermis, hypodermis, parenchymatous cortex, endodermis, pericycle, phloem, cambium, xylem, and pith. This stem shows secondary growth. So in the next part, we'll discuss how this structure of the stem shows secondary.